Let's look at a practical example by comparing two scales. You can see them on the screen. On your left, you can see a scale from the 1940s. This scale used to belong to my grandmother that had a pharmacy in southern Finland. The scale, one on the right, now on my hand, is much smaller. This scale was bought a few years ago by my wife. To evaluate the quality, we shall next look into how these two scales work. The quality evaluation of these two scales would also be called testing. We are basically testing how they work, and through this testing we evaluate their quality. The object that we try to weigh is this cone from a pine tree. Let's start out by testing the kitchen scale. So, the kitchen scale is turned on by pressing this button over here. We can see that it now shows 0 kilograms. No, excuse me, 0 grams. Now to just weigh the object, we place it under the scale. We can see the result of 133 grams. Okay. So now measuring the same cone with the grand old scale. So we turn the scale on by switching this, or moving this lever here, which lifts the different parts of the scale to the air. And now we put the cone in the other end. And we use these weights that have standard, I mean, this weighs 50 grams. And we try to make this thing in the middle to be at the dead center. This is how we weigh this object. So if we take an object of 200 grams, you can see that the cone weighs less than 200 grams. So we have to take this away and put it back here. So if we take an object that weighs 100 grams, you can see that it doesn't quite do it. So then we can add 10 grams. Now we have 110 grams here. It still doesn't quite do it. Now we add a bit more. Now we have 120. If we add just a little more, we have 130. And now we can see that the scale starts to move. But we can see that it doesn't immediately stabilize. Okay, there is still a bit of a swinging going on there. But we can now see the result. So, we can see that we have 130 grams here on the other side. And we have the scaler here in the middle. We can see it's not in the dead center, so it's 3 extra grams on this side. So we can see 1, 2, and 3. So we get that the result is exactly or almost the same as the previous one. So it's 133 grams. Now, on the left, we have 140 grams. This also works in the other way. We can count now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I guess it's roughly crossing the 6. So it's giving a result of 140 minus 6, which is 133 grams. The quality evaluation of these two scales is now complete. And now it is your job to evaluate their quality before you move to the next video. You should consider which of these two scales is better.